Daphne, and today I'll be teaching you guys about simple and complete subjects. Alright, so a simple subject is a main word or main word group in a complete sentence. And a complete subject consists of all words needed to tell who or what a sentence is about.
How are you?
Oh my god, this AP class is stressing me out.
In this example, Raven stated a complete subject and a simple subject. Her statement, "This class is stressing me out," class is the simple subject, and this AP class would be the complete subject.
Santi will point out the simple and complete subjects in the sentence. A large variety of plants and animals have become endangered.
Okay, so looking at the sentence, the word variety is a simple subject because it is the main word. And the complete subject would be a large variety as it shows what the sentence is about, becoming more specific.
Now it's your turn. Find the simple and complete subjects in the sentence. Some animals are threatened by a change in their surroundings.
I'm going to be teaching you about complete and simple predicates. Okay, before I go on telling you about complete and simple predicates, a predicate is the part of a sentence or clause containing a verb and stating something about the subject, just so there aren't any confusions. Okay, so the complete predicate of a sentence is the part that says something about the subject.
Daphne, you're back. How was your trip with your family?
Hey, Santi, our trip was full of many adventures.
In the previous video, our trip was full of many adventures. The complete predicate was full of many adventures because our trip is the subject. The complete predicate is describing how the trip slash the subject was. In the example just used from the skit, this would be the simple predicate. That would be a simple predicate because it's the main and simple verb of the complete predicate. Get it? Okay, cool.
Hi, my name is Mrs. Riggs, and I'm going to be teaching you about compound subjects and compound verbs. A compound subject has two or more connected subjects that have the same verb. Compound sentence parts are usually connected with the words and, or but.
In the sentence, Brianna and Daphne walk down the hallway, there are two subjects, Brianna and Daphne.
The next thing I want you guys to notice is a compound verb. A compound verb has two or more connected verbs that have the same subject.
Okay.
Brianna tripped, fell, and started crying. Trip, fell, and crying are three verbs, and they are all connected to the subject, crayon.
Go.
Try these out. Combine these sentences together. The first one is, a plane lifted off, period. It soared out of sight. The second one is, the bird bath attracts many birds, period. So does the small wooden birdhouse. Baby, does he do it for you? When he's finished. Oh. If you wrote, the plane lifted off and soared out of sight, that is correct. If you also wrote, the bird bath and the small wooden birdhouse
attracts
many birds, that's correct also. This one is an example of a compound verb, and this one is an example of a compound verb.